Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I decided to step outside today because it was getting a little kind of stuffy in the hospital. And I thought before I get called, I would just come out and chat with you briefly about something I've been seeing a little bit more in the hospital as we take care of women who are delivering and women who are postpartum. So please, as you come in, type hello in the chat for me and wave. And if you know anyone else who might benefit from today's topic, please feel free to just send this over, share this this platform with them. And we'll go ahead and get started in a few seconds. I'm sitting outside today. Can you guys hear me okay so far? Thank you. I see that we have one person here. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. Hi, Tyson. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you. Thank you so much for joining. Okay. Awesome. Awesome. If you know anyone else that might benefit from this information, please feel free to like and share. Okay, and we will go ahead and get started. I'm sorry I'm a few minutes late today, guys. I'm here at one of the hospitals, and I wanted to talk today briefly about something I've been seeing coming up very frequently among some of the pregnant and postpartum ladies that we take care of. So please, if you have women in your life who are pregnant or who are soon to be delivered, please share this information with them. I would say thank you guys for joining. I see a couple of other people have joined in. So please feel free to wave to me or type your name in the chat, okay? And if you know of other young ladies who are pregnant or recently delivered, please share this information with them, okay? All right, thank you so much. So let's go ahead and get started. Today we're talking about postpartum birth control. And one of the reasons I really wanted to discuss this is because in the last few, I would say weeks to months, I'm seeing more young ladies who are coming in who either have, hey, Awanda, thank you so much for being here. Hey, Pam, thank you so much for being here. I love you too, cuz. So I'm sitting outside of the hospital today and I'm just gonna talk with you guys very quickly because this is something that I'm seeing a lot. So, you know, we're in the midst of this pandemic and it's been challenging for some folks to basically access the different types of things that they need. And this is especially true in with birth control. And so what I'm seeing probably 10 to 12 in the last couple of months, women who are coming in, they might have a 4 month old or an 8 month old or 1 year old, and they're coming back with new pregnancies. And so I thought this was an important thing to talk about because sometimes people don't have all the information that might be helpful to them in terms of being able to space out or plan their pregnancies. So this quick talk today is not for the person who, you know, wants to get pregnant right away again after they deliver. This talk today is for those who might want some time in between their births so that they can have time to do whatever it is they need. Okay? So just to formally introduce myself, I'm Dr. Madeline, your board-certified OBGYN international speaker and published author. I help busy women access the GYN care and birth control that they might need so that they can live a life that has as much freedom and control that they need to get all their different things done. Hey, Janet, thank you so much for being here today. I appreciate you. So like I was saying, I'm talking about this topic today because we have... I'm seeing more and more young ladies who don't have this information. So three quick things in terms of postpartum birth control, okay? One of the most important things that I try to do with my ladies, and I encourage everyone to bring up this conversation with their provider, if the provider doesn't bring it up, is never too early to talk about birth control, okay? So while you're pregnant, going for your prenatal care visits, bring up the subject, ask the question, hey, you know, what are my options? What types of things can I think about for after I deliver? Okay, one of the reasons I say it's never too early to talk about that conversation is because, you know, more and more these days we have options that we can give women as soon as the placenta is out. So if you've never delivered a baby, you know, we get the baby out, whether it's a vaginal delivery or a C-section, we deliver the placenta, And there are options that we can give women today for birth control before they even leave the delivery room. Okay, so that's important to know and to begin to have that conversation with your provider so that you can discuss some of the different options that are out there. You can discuss pros and cons, and you can feel confident that when you leave, if you get to that 6-week mark and your male partner, if you have a male partner, if they're looking to be sexually active, you can have sex and feel more confident that you're protected. Okay, so we'll talk a little bit more about that later. So again, that's the first thing, starting the discussion about birth control while you're pregnant, while you're still seeing your provider, as one way to increase your chances of being successful with your postpartum birth control. The second thing I want women to know is that when you're talking about your options, when you're considering your options, pretty much everything is on the table except for things that contain estrogen in those first 4 weeks. So what does that mean? When we talk about the implant in the arm, when we talk about many of the types of IUDs, well, all of the IUDs, none of them have estrogen in them. So those are among the ones that can be started as soon as you deliver your baby and your placenta. Okay, so those are definitely things to think to keep in mind. If you're someone who likes the combination birth control pill, and that's a birth control pill that has both estrogen and progestin, then you need to wait until about 4 weeks after you deliver, because right after you deliver a baby, you have a higher chance of forming blood clots in your body. And of course, we wouldn't want any blood clot to get loose and go to your lungs or your heart, because that can be a matter of life and death. And so that's the main reason why for birth control, we don't prescribe anything that has estrogen in it in those weeks right after you deliver, okay? But you can have anything that has progestin in it, very popular. Hey, Michelle, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you. Very popular are for women who like to take the pill every day. You can take a pill that only has progestin in it. You don't take a pill that has estrogen in it in those first few weeks, okay? Certainly you can do something like that later on in the pregnancy. Later on in the postpartum period, but not in those first few weeks. And so again, the first thing was you can start the discussion for postpartum birth control while you're still pregnant, so that you have a plan that's ready to go as soon as you deliver. And again, plans can be implemented in the delivery room as soon as the placenta is out. The second thing is that everything is really on the table in terms of your options, except for things that contain estrogen in those first few weeks, okay? So that's important to know. What's the third thing? So the third thing is, and this is where I think a lot of people get caught up, is that, sometimes when women first deliver the baby and they first go home, they're thinking they don't want necessarily anything to do with sex. And then, you get to that 6-week point, and if your partner is a male or the woman herself, she might start to, her hormones are gonna get back and to where they were, and she might be ready to have sex. One of the things that, one of the reasons why pre-planning for postpartum birth control is so important is that when you get to that point of, when you're 6 weeks out or 8 weeks out and you feel ready to resume sex, you can have sex and not be as worried about having a pregnancy too soon. Again, like I said in the beginning, this is not for those women who are trying to have, the stair-step kids. This is for those women who, right after they deliver, they want to space out their pregnancies and they want to have some time. So the third thing to keep in mind is that when you get to that 6-week postpartum point, it's important to, if you know you are ready to become sexually active, that you try to have something on board. Michelle said, thank you for this conversation. I don't recall having any type of conversation like this during my child rearing years. Great insight so I can share with my daughters. Absolutely, Michelle. Thank you so much. And that's one reason why I wanted to get this information out there, because whether it's us or whether we're, aunties or moms or just friends with other sister friends and other women, it's important that other women have this information. Like I said in the beginning of the talk today, I've seen maybe 10 to 12 women in the last few weeks who have 4 months olds or one year olds, and they're coming in newly pregnant and they didn't necessarily intend to be pregnant. Okay, so hopefully this information is helpful to them and to all of us. And so one other thing I want to say about postpartum birth control. Breastfeeding is not 100% effective, y'all. Okay, I really want to underscore that, because that's a myth that a lot of women think is the case, but breastfeeding is not 100% protective as birth control. It does not prevent you from getting pregnant. So let me break that down just a little bit. If you are exclusively breastfeeding, that means if you're truly giving your baby the breasts and the breast milk or pumping on demand every 3 to 4 hours, and you know, and you're doing that consistently, maybe for like the first 3 months, then your chances are higher that you won't ovulate and have an egg that's out there to become fertile. However, if you're not breastfeeding at that pace, or when you begin to wean and shift to like more formula, or maybe the baby gets to like 4 or 6 months and they start taking more solid food, it's absolutely imperative that you don't think that breastfeeding is protecting you from getting pregnant. So that's something else to keep in mind. Can you take birth control while you're breastfeeding? Absolutely. Anything that has, particularly the progestin things that I mentioned earlier, those are great because there are some studies, older studies, that used to say that anything with estrogen in it would decrease your breast milk supply. Now, many of those studies haven't held up over the years, but most providers still like to wait until a woman's breast milk production has really come in and is nice and full. So, just quickly, I'm gonna just summarize the three things that I really wanted to bring home today in terms of postpartum birth control. The first thing, which I think is really, really important, please tell the young women or the women who might be pregnant or postpartum in your worlds that these conversations absolutely should be started while they're still pregnant in terms of what type of postpartum birth control they might be interested in, when they want to start it, and what some of their different options are. Okay, so start the discussion while pregnant. And there are some women who are like, okay, well, you know, that's not really something my provider, my doctor, my midwife, or someone talks about. I always encourage women to try to find a provider who they feel is listening to them, is able to hear them out, so that they can ask questions, express concerns, and be able to ultimately get what they need. Okay, so that's the first thing. Start the discussion while pregnant. Number two, know that all of the options are on the table except in that first month, anything that has estrogen in it. So that would be risky because of the increased ability to form blood clots in those first few weeks after delivery. And what's the third thing? If you are in a space where you are ready to resume your sexual activity at 6 weeks, which is very normal because most women or most people want to be able to resume as soon as they can, if you are ready to resume at 6 weeks and you want some space before your next pregnancy, please make sure you have your birth control on board so that you can have, you know, what I love to say is worry-free sex. And there are many different options out there of birth control that can allow you to have worry-free sex where you're not thinking, oh my goodness, you know, do I have to now worry about a pregnancy that I didn't necessarily plan for because I don't have my birth control on board. So I want to, I just wanted to share that with you guys today. If you have any questions, please type it in the chat. I'm doing this on my phone right outside of the hospital today. Just wanted to get some fresh air because there was just so much going on inside the hospital. But, you know, just trying to stay safe and trying to make sure you guys are able to stay informed. And certainly if you have any questions about different birth control options, please, you know, type it to me in the chat or send it to me in DM, and I will do my best to make sure that I get back to you and get you the information you need. Okay, so I want to thank you guys for joining me today. I will be back next Sunday. If you have some specific questions you want to ask about, feel free to send those to me also in DM. And I did get some more questions about the vaccines. Now that the vaccines are rolling out, I got some questions about that, and if you want, we can talk about that next week. So okay, well, I am glad that you guys were able to log on for today. Again, thank you for being here. So just as a quick recap, postpartum birth control, very important. Hey, Lee, hey, Number, thank you so much for being here. So just a quick recap, postpartum birth control. Number one, start the discussion while still pregnant. Number two, everything is on the table except for estrogen-containing birth control pills and those first, or the patch or the ring in those first few weeks after delivery. And number three, if at all possible, have something in place before that 6-week visit, or before 6 weeks when it's usually okay to resume sexual activity, and that way you won't get caught out there and you can have as much worry-free and joyful sex as you like. So, closing for today, this is Dr. Madeline, your board certified OBGYN, international speaker and published author. I help busy women access GYN care and accurate information and birth control that they need to have the most freedom and control over their lives so that they can live their best possible life and have worry-free, joyful sex. Please follow me on social media outlets. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram as Dr. Madeline, MD. So thank you again. Oh, okay, great. Pamela says, yes, would love to hear more about the vaccine. Thank you. Great information to know and share with young women. Thank you. Thank you, Pam. And thank you so much for sharing the information. And next week, yes, I will do an update about the COVID vaccine, particularly because I've been looking at a lot of the safety data. And me personally, I'm actually leaning more toward going ahead and getting it. So I'm going to share some of the updated science with you guys, give you also some details about why I'm now leaning that way. And you guys can ask me any questions that come up. All right. Thank you so much, y'all. I love y'all. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Okay. Bye-bye.